Let's start with supply, though. What are you expecting to hear from Alcoa about supply?
I think they're going to point to continued strong production globally. That's really been the hallmarks of the global aluminium market for the last 5 years or so.
How deep might we expect the surplus to be this year?
On our numbers, we reckon 1.4 million tons of aluminium oversupply this year.
And how does that compare to the last 5 years? And are prices reflecting this kind of surplus?
Yes, I think they were. If we look at the last 5 years, we've probably had a cumulative surplus of around 2.5 million tons already.
And what has actually kept prices supported?
It's been the fact that the aluminium oversupply has forced the forward curve into contango. Mm-hmm. So there's been the forward contango financing locking up the oversupply in warehouses.
And so that's just basically using aluminium to get financing. What about the actual demand for the stuff that we use in, say, cars and houses?
Aluminium is one of the fastest growing metals out of the industrial metals complex, growing anywhere between 7 to 10% a year, heavily used in transportation and packaging. Those are the two key sectors.
So despite this oversupply, we're having demand grow about 10% a year. How does that compare to other industrial metals that are also entering a surplus like copper?
Copper, for example, would be growing anywhere between 2 to 3% a year. Lead and zinc, probably a little higher, maybe 3 to 4%. Nickel would be the closest to aluminum, maybe growing at around 5 to 6% a year.
So when you're looking at aluminum prices and this sort of offshoot of supply and demand here, how would you trade aluminum?
Well, we actually think the downside's limited because the price has fallen to the cost of production. So we think the downside's limited. There is scope because of strong demand for prices to rally. At the same time, we think that copper's moving into a surplus, maybe can fall further. So we quite like a short copper, long aluminium trade, maybe for the next 3 to 6 months.
So Adam, not as necessarily bearish on aluminum. It's more a supply versus demand problem for prices.
Yeah, and very specific to the individual metals. Joe Tanius, again, strategist over at JP Morgan Wealth. I'm curious, industrial demand for commodities, what's your take?
You know, last year we didn't really see commodities overall outperform too well broadly because despite the fact that you've got central banks accommodating and easing, which of course is generally a good thing for commodities, global demand was just weakening. You take a look at what was going on in China and really across all of the emerging markets, slowing down. Now this year, we do believe we are in a part where the emerging markets are actually starting to pick up a little bit of momentum. We're seeing it in some of the data coming out of Asia, and I think ultimately that'll translate into LATAM. Once that actually
LATAM
happens.
LATAM being Latin America.
Exactly, Latin America. And so I think once that happens, eventually down the road, at some point this year, you're probably going to see demand for commodities pick up. And as a result of that, you'll probably see prices then follow through shortly afterwards.
So you're bullish on some cyclicals here in the U.S., like technology because of business spending, but it sounds like at least for the commodity trade, it's going to take some more time, another couple of quarters.
Exactly. I think we need to wait for that to happen. We first need to see growth actually pick up and escalate in parts around the world. And from there, I think industrial demand for metals and aluminum and things of that nature will actually start to pick up.
And then you'd buy the commodity stocks. Yeah. Alex?
Adam. Robin, I want to ask you a final question here on the aluminum financing that you alluded to. How critical is this for aluminum demand and what happens when it disappears? What's the downside risk?
It's very critical. We don't think it disappears anytime soon because the cost of funding, which is low interest rates, we see continuing maybe for another 2 years or so. But when US rates start to rise, probably towards the 2%, maybe 3%, that could be the end of this financing trade. Mm-hmm. Therefore, the risk is a huge amount of metal finally reaching the physical markets, possibly pressuring prices significantly lower.
I'm going to squeeze in one quick question here. With aluminum demand about 7 to 10% a year, what can we extrapolate in terms of the global economy, the health of it?
I think we can extrapolate that the economy is doing okay, but it's not like Dr. Copper. You know, I don't think you can read through aluminum the health or the barometer of the global economy as you could do for copper, for example. But it gives us some insight into, I think, a reasonably healthy global economy.